we do not believe religious politics or politics of religion solves any problem, be it Christian or Muslim. We do not differentiate between moderate and radical religious tendency. It doesn't solve the problems of the real problems of communities and nations, because it could be one way of expressing injustice or fighting for, like the black Americans in the United States, when they felt they were discriminated, they had to resort to the church and pray to God that they be relieved from all the injustices they face, economic injustice, social injustice, political, cultural injustice. It happens in societies. When human beings get desperate, they resort to God, they resort to religion, they resort to something that is not temporal. That is phenomenal in our region. But we have never entertained this idea of radical Islam or Sharia becoming a solution. How can one justify Eritrea sympathizing or supporting? The situation in Somalia is a completely different story. It's a problem of a nation that is this, that has disintegrated. It's a question of a nation that has gone into crisis, internal and external crisis. Somalia does not exist. And that is the main issue in Somalia for us, at least in Eritrea. And Somalia is part of the Horn of Africa. When you have one country or one nation divided and fragmented from within, it's Somaliland, it's Puntland, it's Banaderland, it's so many lands, but beyond that, it's fragmented into clans, into tribes, into warlordism. That is very sad, and that reality has its effect on the Horn of Africa. Somalia is no other country. It's not like Eritrea. It's more than any other nation in the country. The instability in Somalia affects the stability of the whole region. And that's what we have witnessed the last 20 years. We would like Somalia to revive. We would like this nation to come to normalcy again and contribute to the stability in the region.